Hello everyone, this is Karen Dissin. Hope you all doing well. In today's video, I'll be talking about how to eat after you have had a stroke. So if you like the video related to my health, my way, I would like to request you all, please do subscribe to the channel, hit the bell icon and give thumbs up so that I will come up with more and more videos with lots and lots of information. So here we begin, let's go. In the wake of a stroke, many things about your life may be different, including your diet. Changing the way you eat can help reduce your risk of having another stroke. A healthy diet will also ensure your body is getting the nutrients it needs to support neurological and physical healing. In almost any circumstance, it's about or is good to re-evaluate what you are eating and your lifestyle after having a stroke. Okay, so notes that a person's diet and exercise habits are among the main factors that contribute to cardiovascular disease and stroke, and that looking out for overall heart health is an important factor in reducing your risk for stroke. We can fix a stent in an artery, but it's a temporary measure that needs to be coupled with the lifestyle changes to prevent recurrence of not only stroke but heart disease. So both Chen and Dr. Freeman recommend that people follow the basic rules of the Mediterranean and dietary approaches to stop hypertension, ways of eating to ensure that best overall health and to reduce that risk of having another stroke. The DASH diet was specifically designed to reduce high blood pressure, the single biggest risk factor for having a stroke, according to the American Stroke Association. Both diet include large amount of fresh vegetables, fruits, nuts, beans, legumes, fish and poultry in moderation, and very few servings of processed food, dairy, red meat and sweets. The American Heart Association recognized that both the Mediterranean and DASH ways of eating can have a big impact on a person's risk of stroke. The biggest thing to cut back on are sugar, salt, highly processed food, saturated and trans fat and fried food, as well as snacky type food, referring to packaged snack food including pretzels and chips. Here are some tips for what to eat and what to avoid to help you recover from a stroke. Eat whole, mostly plant-based food and lots of veggies. Whole foods are those that are in as close to their natural state as possible once they reach your plate. Fruit, vegetables, nuts, nuts, beans, rice and fish are all good. Examples of whole foods, says Freeman, who adds that when choosing vegetables, opt for more leafy greens, asparagus, peppers, onion, carrot, Brussels sprouts and other non-starchy vegetable over potatoes and corn. He also says to be careful of what kind of toppings you put on vegetable. If you are going to eat salads and cover them in bacon and blue cheese, that negates their health benefits. Says Freeman, instead try adding vinegars to salad, including balsamic, and consider adding nuts or seeds to keep a meal of leafy greens healthy. Now, avoid processed food, salt and sugar. Processed food are the opposite of whole food. These food typically come pre-packaged and include options like cereal, crackers, certain bread, chips and processed meats like luncheon meat and bacon. Processed food typically contain a lot of sugar and salt, which may contribute to plaque buildup that can cause an ischemic stroke, says Chen. She recommends rarely eating sugary foods such as desserts and pastries and replacing sugary beverages with water. Drinks that include added sugar are the simple largest source of sugar in the American diet, according to the Harvard T.H. Chan School of Public Health. And according to the Centers of Disease Control and Prevention, half of all American adults drink at least one sugary beverage on any given day. One study of California teachers published in May 2020 in the Journal of the American Heart Association found that women who consumed one or more sugary beverages, which included soda, energy or sport drink and fruit juice with added sugar, were 20% more likely to have a stroke than women who rarely drank sugary beverages. Excess sugar caused weight gain and type 2 diabetes, both risk factors for stroke. In fact, people who have diabetes are 1.5 times more likely to have a stroke than people who do not, according to the American Diabetes Association. Another risk factor for stroke is high blood pressure, and salt is directly related to high blood pressure, according to AHA. The AHA recommend consuming no more than 2300 milligrams of sodium a day, and that can add up quickly, especially if you eat a lot of prepackaged food or processed meat, opting for whole food over processed food and seasoning meals with herbs, spices or citrus instead of salt is a good way to cut back on sodium intake. That's all about the diabetes in this video. I hope you all liked it. I'll definitely come in the next video with my another content. Till then, God bless you. Bye bye and take care.